please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Sunil Kanoria, Vice Chairman of SREI Infra, now joins us. Mr. Kanoria, good afternoon. The very fact that you had to send communication to the exchanges is indicating that perhaps something is wrong?
No, not necessary. There's nothing wrong. That is why we have to send the communication. Because I believe there have been some apparent wrong information going out in the market.
Okay.
And therefore, we have to be informed to all our stakeholders that our business is strong and we are in a strong, stable position. We have gone through many challenges in the past and we have, because of our prudent risk management at ALM, we have managed our situation fairly well and even now.
Okay, so, in terms of your debt positions, has there been any default? Because that's the one area which the market was concerned with.
Which is what we are disputing, that there has been zero default ever in the last 30 years, neither now. Mm. We have surplus liquidity which we have parked with liquid funds. And because we have a strong liquidity management and ALM risk management practice in place, not since when RBI came out with, but since 97, when international institutions in pinch day, since then we have been following that prudent norms, and therefore we sustained, survived, grew even during the toughest times, whether it was the 97-98 crisis, whether it was the 2008 crisis, or even now the challenge is there in the market.
Okay, Mr. Kanoria, I just have a quick question, specific ones there. Right now, your liability side, how much money is coming from mutual funds? I think you mentioned 950 crores. Is that all? As a percentage,
I'm sorry you didn't get me. I said 950 crores we have invested in mutual funds on the asset. On the liability side, let me tell you, we do not take mutual funds money for our business. We only use that for our interest arbitrage. We do not allow, as a principle, we do not allow any mismatch of our asset liability. So we are well covered on our asset liability matching. We are, as per our risk mandate and as per our company policy for the last 20 years now, we do not follow any risk, ALM risk. Okay.
So just some more numbers on that. If you could
but
just...
I cannot give you numbers on that.
Okay, how much money have you raised via CPs in the recent past, Mr. Kanoria?
I'm sorry, I cannot give you offhand numbers like that.
No, but is there something that has to be redeemed in next 1 month or next 1 year?
I'm sorry, those numbers I cannot give you offhand like that.
But sir, how do you expect confidence then to come back, sir? I mean, the question that Anuj is asking, all we need to know is your repayment commitments that are coming up over the next 6 months to 1 year.
We can only say that all our repayment commitments have been met till now and will be met in the future.
No, Mr. Kanoria, you can't issue a BSA statement saying that, everything is fine and then, say that I don't have those numbers offhand, because that is what the market is worried about. So you need to have perhaps those numbers or at least some kind of ballpark numbers that you can give us. Because the stock, I tell you, is not recovering even after all your clarifications.
So, that is, I leave it to that market to that, but we know how we are managing the situation, our business, and we are fairly strongly well positioned to manage all our. We are mandated by our risk policy and governance to ensure that, and we are taking well care of it. So we do not have any mismatches of our liabilities. And
but sir, I'm not understanding. Why is it that you are not sharing the numbers in terms of your payment?
I'm sorry, it's not an issue of sharing. I do not have those numbers offhand with me because they are businesses, this treasury is managing it. We give a policy statement from the board and we monitor that to ensure that from our risk committees, from our ALM committees, which we monitor the businesses, that we do not allow the business and the treasury. So even if we are taking money from the mutual fund, whether from CP or from mutual fund, that is basically parked in our credit line with the bank.
Can you give us some breakup of the liability profile, sir? Can you tell us how much of your funds that you're getting, how much is bank exposure? You said mutual funds is only arbitrage.
We have majority of our funding, 90%, 95% of our funding is from banks, institutions and international institutions and the bond market.
No, sir, I'm trying to ask the breakup. Mutual funds and banks. I'm trying to get the breakup.
from the mutual funds is very negligible. It's not even more than 5 to 10% of my overall book.
And CPs?
Both. The mutual funds, CP comes from mutual funds only. So basically, mutual fund CPs are not even more than 5 to 10% of my book.
Okay. So,
what I'm trying to explain. That is what I'm trying to explain. If I look at my exposures to mutual funds through CPs or through mutual fund exposure, is negligible. Not even 5 to 10% of my overall book.
So
we don't take that. We don't believe in basically having the mismatch of liabilities and assets.
Is the IPO of SREI Equipment Finance, are those timelines intact as per what you last told us?
If the markets are good, and the markets, there will be a market. When I'm going to the market, I would need to have investors. With this sentiment, obviously, we can't immediately come out with the IPO. Mm-hmm. Let's wait and watch how the market improves and get the sentiment back. This is, to my mind, it's basically a knee-jerk reaction by the market. Fine, we have to go through it. It was a crisis in 2008 also. The market went overcome that and grew. So I feel this environment and time will also pass by. And I'm sure people will realize the value of the businesses and then provide their support.
All right, Mr. Kanoria, we leave it there for now.